We talked today, the thesis of Professor Majchrowski talking about heritage, is it an open stage or is it something new that we're building on the rocks of the previous civilization? Or is it a new state that we have to define once again and found ourselves in it? And this moment in which we are now is a question, is it a moment in the evolution or a revolution that we can see? Or maybe an interruption of the continuation of one civilization and the outbreak of a new civilization. I think that we are still on the stage when we look from the point of view that Professor has mentioned. I think it's rather evolution, because we see that some processes, some progress to achieve the desired forms of organization when we talk about the law in the 20th century, according to many before given hypotheses, they found themselves close to the ideal that people have had invented before, and when it comes to benefit of political freedom, they can gather the wealth, they can get involved in politics, and the country is much less repressive than the country that was hundreds of years ago when it comes to guarantee the justice, sense of justice. And maybe the moment that was aimed for many, many years and took place in the 20th century became the moment in which those hypotheses from the previous years and centuries turned out that there is a new ideal, because this is not what we are aiming to. And here we have this question: is this moment that for some people wasn't that the aim, or is it just the beginning of something new? And when we look at the aspect of this battle, actually, because when you look at the title of this panel and those declarations that we have seen during this conference, the heritage, the university, we can't hide that this is a kind of we try to answer if these values, are they close to what we consider freedom in an American way, created by many thinkers of previous centuries? They were showing us that the human being has to live in a society. He has to aim to live in a republic. When we think about Vincente Kadubek, and it becomes his chronicle begins, the Respublika, in our society, we see the idea as a republic. Well, it is not totally the way that the direction that the nowadays world has taken. We see that why have we renewed the idea of the university? Why? Because its idea, which is developing for so many years now, is an idea completely different, is a closed idea to any polemic, to any tradition. It tries to subordinate everything to the doctrine of ideology, of politics. And many people see that it threatens other values and sensitivities. And this is also the moment of truth that our editor here has mentioned. We are thinking if universities, in a classical way, in many places in the world, also in Poland, becomes a place where it has been referred to, which is the freedom of speech, of thought, of research, and also of presenting one's own views, or today we see it's rather closed. So if we see at the level of higher education, there has been some big change. Can't we see, can we think that this trend would be dominant also in the law? Is it built, this trend, on the legal rules that are to be kept vigilant? This view that we see today, that not every thought is desired that can enter into life, will bring us to the very good legal methods to build a new society.
As
the professor has mentioned about the difference, the biological one, the gender one, which is a creation from the last few decades. The second article of the European Treaty says that there is equality between men and women. This is one of the values of the European Union. And the fight against this inequality. So there are lots of legal acts of different importance. And usually the motives of those loans are
dziwnym trafem w ostatnich latach.
Or much more the same. In last year, some notions that were assumed as granted many years ago now disappear from the streets, like a man and a woman, yes? But when this second article finishes in other official EU documents, the last few words are cut. They are replaced by gender equality, not men and women equality. And this is what we are discussing today, in the extent of the role of the law, the role of the law in our civilization. It is the possibility of making from new words new laws. And when somebody gets into notions, then the law is affected. Not as we simply think, okay, there is some new rule, some new act, and everybody should obey it. No, it happens on the way, on the level, on the EU, in every small act, they introduce this notion. And later, there is a further discussion. For example, on the based on the foundation of the civilization, how it should work, how the society should be functioning. There are many acts, bills, laws, and people who try to question those acts. But you know, in your law, it's been present for so many years. Why are you questioning that? Here you ask, our moderator asks, how does it change the law? And today, the answer to the challenges that we face and we discuss during those consequent panels and the discussion that the public discussion that we see nowadays, in my opinion, we are at the point that the tools that were created by our civilization, such as a place where we could realize ourselves, our freedom, today those tools are being used to create a state that actually limits the freedom of their citizen. So for so many years, the human being tries to be as free as possible. The laws created by Republic are serving to this purpose. But actually, nowadays, By changing those laws, we cancel all those frames that before were the guarantee of the order. And this is what is a key point when we talk about freedom. Nowadays, those mechanisms are very subtle. The problem of gender, as you have mentioned before, is just one of them. But the redefinition of expectations of the freedom, there are much more of that. And the law and the heritage, the legal heritage, we can say, of our culture area is simply just a tool to implement those programs.